So let us learn about matrix multiplication today. I'll be telling you the logic behind this matrix multiplication. I'll be explaining you the logic behind the matrix multiplication. You people need to write down the code for this one. I'll tell you the logic behind that, and you need to write down the code for this. And you compile this one and show, and you can check the output, because as part of assignment, I have already given you this one. Right, so let us learn about this matrix multiplication. Is my voice clear now? Some of you have told like the voice is breaking. Is it breaking? Right, good, thank you. So you all know what is nothing but a two-dimensional array. I'll just revise once. Array is nothing but a variable which will be holding more than one value, and all values should be of same data type. That is the definition of an array. Now, if you want to store one row of array elements, one row of elements, then we can go with one-dimensional array. But if you want to store a table of data or a matrix type of data, then you need to store the value in the values in the form of rows and columns. Got it? Where each row will be having multiple values. So that is represented in the form of rows and columns. In that case, we need to represent our array. Let us consider that array is A. Then you need to represent two dimensions like this, where the first dimension will be, this will be talking about the row size, and this will be talking about the column size. You all are familiar with this one, how it should be declared, how it should be initialized. All these things you already know, how two-dimensional arrays can be initialized at runtime and at compile time. All these things we have already learned. Got it? So now, by using that thing, let us perform the matrix multiplication. Got it? Normally, whenever we want to perform matrix multiplication, what we need to have, we need to have two arrays, isn't it or not? So what we can do, let us consider two arrays like this. A is one array and B is the other array. And after performing the addition, let us store that value in another array, that is C, because after performing multiplication also, that the result, whatever we are getting normally in mathematics, whatever you have done, if you see, the result is also of two-dimensional array only. So let us store our result in C. So C will be holding the value and A of the result, and A will be holding the input of first array, and B will be holding the input of second two-dimensional array. Now, how normally you will be declaring, let me first highlight the points, whatever we need to do for performing the matrix multiplication. What is the first thing? First thing is we need to declare all the arrays that are required in our program. So in our program, we require, one second. Okay, so what is the first thing we need to do? We need to first declare the arrays, and declaration is nothing but we need to tell the name of the array and what is the size we want to mention for that array. In our application, that is matrix multiplication, we require two arrays to hold the input values and one more array to hold the output of our multiplication values. Got it? So we require A. How you will be declaring, we'll be doing later. What is the next step? After declaring the array, we need to ask the user to enter the values for A and B, or else we can still make it little bit customized. Like, we can ask the user to enter the size of arrays, like matrix A, what is the row size and column size, and matrix B, what is the row size and column size. Let us consider array A. If you consider the matrix size, let us consider it is R1 and R1 by C1. Let us consider the row size, the matrix size of A matrix. Then if you consider B, let us consider for B, it is R2 by C2. Follow carefully, all of you. Got it? Array size of A is R1 by C1. Array size of B is R2 by C2. Now you need to ask the user to enter the size of R1 and C1 and store it in R1 and C1. And array size of B is R2 and C2. R stands for row, C stands for column. Understood, all of you? Why we need to ask this one? Because normally for matrix addition, the row size and column size should be same. But For multiplication, it may not be the case. You can have different row size and column size for A and B. Got it? But to perform the matrix multiplication, we need to observe some logic behind it. What is that? You need to check. You need to check normally whenever you are performing matrix multiplication, if R1 and C1 is the row size of A and R2 and C2 is size of B. Now we need to check one condition, because whenever you are performing a matrix multiplication, the column size of first matrix should be equal to the row size of second matrix, isn't it or not? You all know about this. Let me take one example. I will be taking Let me take one example. If you see, let us consider this is matrix A. The size of this matrix is, what is the size of this matrix? Two rows and three columns, isn't it or not? Two rows and three columns. Let me take one more matrix. The size of this matrix, let us consider this is B. The size of this matrix is 3 by 2, isn't it or not? Now, if you want to perform matrix multiplication, this matrix, if you want to multiply with this one, what can we do? What can we do? Always this row size, this column size should be equal to this row size, isn't it or not? So what we can have? So we need to have a condition here. After reading the size of an array, we need to have a condition. Check C1 is equal to R2 or not. If it is equal, then only we need to perform the matrix multiplication. Isn't it or not? If the column size of this one is equal to this row size, then only we can perform matrix multiplication. If it is not equal, we can't perform the matrix multiplication. Isn't it or not? If it is equal, then what can we do? Within this, we can have one more. We can start processing our thing. We need to read the values of A and B matrix. If the size is capable enough to perform the matrix in multiplication, then only we will be reading the values. If it is not equal, then why to read the values of A and B? Got it? So whenever the column size of A matrix and the row size of B matrix, which is R2 and C1, if both are equal, then only we can perform the matrix multiplication. In that case, we will be reading the values of A and B. Got it? Got it, all of you? So after reading the A and B values, we need to write down the logic to perform matrix multiplication. Right? After performing the logic to perform the matrix multiplication, what you need to do? You need to display the perform the logic to perform the matrix multiplication. This we'll see in detail. After performing the matrix multiplication, display or print values of C. What will be C having? C will be having the total product of these two matrices A and B. So, but suppose if the value C1 and C2 are not equal, in such a case, what you need to do? In such a case, you need to display what you need to display? You need to display matrix multiplication is not possible. Okay. If you can write here, if C1 is equal to C2, else, what do you mean by that one? Matrix I hope you all are clear with this structure now. Got it, all of you? We need to declare the arrays first. After that, we need to read the array size of A and B matrices. And then we need to check the column size of A with the row size of B. If it is equal, then only we'll be proceeding further, or else we will be simply displaying matrix multiplication is not possible. Got it? Now let us follow these steps one by one. So what is the first step we need to do? What is the first step we need to do? We need to declare the arrays. So I'll be writing the code. Follow carefully. Don't bother about these this capital letters and small letters. Just concentrate on the thing what we are going to learn. Okay? In we need to declare the arrays first. So we need to specify some size. So I'm specifying. We need to specify minimum size of any array that you are going to declare. What happens with that is memory will be allocated of that size. Okay. So I'm declared. So the maximum value that can be stored is 10 rows, with each row having 10 values. So 100 values can be stored in array A, array B, and array C, and it is up to you. Below that, any values can be stored. So we have done the declaration part. Got it, all of you? Now, after declaration, what you need to do, that this is our first step is done. So let me cross this. Now, what is the second step? We need to ask the user to enter the size of A matrix and B matrix. So for that, our notation is R1 C1 for A, R2 C2 for B. So we need to declare those things also, R1 C1 R2 C2. Got it? Now, let us ask the user, what is that? Printf, enter row and column size of matrix A. This you need to write, and we will be reading these values in A, in what is that one? R1 and R2. Sorry, R1 and C1. Got it? So we got the values for first matrix. Similarly, we need to write down the same statements. What is the next statement? Enter the row and column size of matrix B. So we will be storing that in R2 and C2. Got it? So we have done our second step also. Enter the size of A, read the size of matrix A and matrix B. Let us strike out this. Now, what is the next thing we need to do? We need to check whether C1 and R1 are equal or not. So to do that task, what can we do? We can use our selection statement, that is if. In that if, you can directly write, if C1 is equal to R2, then only we will be writing our logic. Okay, we will be writing our logic inside this. If it is not equal, then that we will be writing our logic. This part I'll tell you later. Else, but if it is not equal, what you need to do, we will be displaying matrix multiplication is not possible. So we will be writing our else part here. So in the else part, what I want to do is, I want to just write printf matrix multiplication is not possible. This is our else part. So this is also done. Now we are left with this part only. So we need to concentrate on this logic. Got it, all of you? So now let us see. Let us fill out all the statements that are required to be filled in this if statement. Now, what is the first thing we need to do? If both are equal, then matrix multiplication is possible. In such a case, we need to read the values of A and B matrix. Now, you all know how to read the matrix values of A and B. Can you tell me how we will be reading the values of A matrix or B matrix? What is the logic behind that? You all have done that. Yes, we need to use for loop. One for loop is to mention the row size, and the other for loop is to mention the column size. Right? So let us use the same thing. And I will not be explaining you this one because we have already learned this. And for A, what is the row size? R1 and C1. And for B, the row size is R2 and column size is C2. So we need to use this one. Let me add one printf statement here because we want the user to know this. Printf, enter the values of A matrix. Observe here where we are writing these statements. We are writing these statements in the if. Only when this condition satisfies, then only it will be asking the user to enter the values. So first I'm asking the values of A matrix, right? Okay, again in this I can have one more for loop. J, I need to declare this I and j, that declaration part and all, you please take care of that. So if you forget also, you will get an error at the time of compilation, and then you can go back and declare those things. So scanf percentage d comma, got it? So this is the statement. These three are the statements that I use to perform the reading of values of matrix A. Remember, I have not kept the flower brands also, because I have only one statement for this, for it will be executing. Got it? Now the same statements can be copied, sorry, and the same statements can be copied, and we can perform the same thing for matrix B, where we need to store the values in B, and this should be R2 and this should be C2. I hope you all are clear with this one. So we have done this part also, reading the values of A and B matrix. Got it? Now we need to perform. We are in our the real logic of performing the matrix multiplication. Up to here, all of you clear? All of you, how we have done all the other steps, is that clear to all of you? Very good. Now let us see the how to perform the matrix multiplication. Remember, normally addition is very simple, where normally this value should be added to this value, provided that the row size and column size of both the matrix is the same, and this value should be added with this value, and we will be getting the result. But for matrix multiplication, that is not the case. So what is the thing we need to do? Normally we need to start with I equal to 0. Listen carefully, all of you. We need to start with I equal to, this is row value 0, let us consider. And with this, we need to consider column value. This is the row value and this is the column value. So what we are talking, we are taking the row size of A matrix and we are taking the column size of B matrix. Follow carefully. Now what we are doing, the row size is fixed here. What is the row size? Here also the row size is fixed. Here also the row size is fixed. Here the column size is fixed. For the first time, we need to take this column, and second time we need to fix this column, and third time we need to fix this column. Got it? Now let us first understand about this first row and this second column. Right. Now in the first row, which is our A, for 0, we need to start from 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2. Are you understanding? And for the second thing, we need to take 1 0 0 0 1 0, and what is this one? 2 0. Are you understanding what I am saying? This is 0 0 0 1, this is 0 2, this is 0 0, this is 1 0, and this is 1 1. If you observe here, let me write here. One more thing I'll tell you. After performing the matrix multiplication, what is the final result of your C matrix? Can you tell me? Yeah, this is 3 by 3. Yeah. 3 by 3. This is 3 by 3. No, I have taken 3 by 3. Right? So what is the final matrix of the final product? You will be getting the row size of your first matrix and the column size of your second matrix, isn't it or not? So your third matrix, whichever you are considering, is of 2 by 3. So this is your C matrix, right? This is your B matrix. This is your C matrix, and the size of this one will be 2 by 3. So this is 3 by 3. Now this row size and this column size and this row size is matching, so the final value will be 2 by 3. Now can we write a logic? I'll be writing the logic here only. All of you follow carefully. I'll write a logic here. Now we need to repeat this one how many times? 2 times, 3 times. I value should be 2 times and j value should be 3 times to get your final value. So we can have for loop for I equal to, I am writing the logic for matrix multiplication. Same thing I'll put where, again I'll put here in this If okay, for your understanding, I'm writing here. So for I equal to 0, I less than row size is 2, which is 2. This is R1 because for A we are considering it is R1, so we will be writing R1 I plus plus, and for J equal to, I'm taking one more iteration because I am talking about the column size. J less than, what is this 3? This 3 we got from here. This 3 is belonging to this C2, isn't it or not? So we need to write C2 J plus plus. So for your understanding, I'll put the flower vases also. Okay, now here we need to write down our logic. What is our logic? Where we are going to store our value? We are going to store our value in this one, in this location. Now that can be represented as C of I J, right? Now let us write down what is the statement that is required to perform the matrix multiplication. Follow carefully. J equal to 0. Okay, J value starts from 0. J less than C2. J plus plus, and we are performing the matrix values or performing the matrix multiplication. We want to store the value in a particular location. Now, if you want to get this value, can you tell me how we are getting this value? How you are getting this value? This value we will be getting by multiplying this value with this value. What is this? These two values, can you tell me? I'll write here. Or else, let me add one more text box. Okay. Now, can you tell me how we will be getting this value? I'll be highlighting this one. Okay. Okay. Now, this value we can get, whatever first value we have, this value we can get by multiplying this value with this value and adding that value with the multiplication of these two. Let me write that one. How you can get A of, sorry, we can write here A of 0, 0. Follow carefully, all of you. A of 0, 0 should be multiplied with, what is this value? Not one, should be multiplied. I will copy, someone has written already. I'll make use of that. Very good, thank you. So we need to perform A of 0, 0 multiplied with V of 0, 0, right? After that, these two should be multiplied. What is this one? This is A of 0, 1, right? And this should be multiplied with, what is this one? V of 1, 0. Got all of you? And then this is equal to A of 0, 2. Are you understanding, all of you? And this should be equal to A of 2, 0. Right, this is our matrix multiplication. How we got this value? This value is equal to A of this we need to perform to get this value, right? Now, if you observe here, the value of 0 is fixed. 0, 0. What is this one? This is also A of, I have done something wrong. If you see here, for A matrix, this value is fixed. 0, 1, 2. But the first value is fixed, all of you. What is this first value? We are in the iteration of I equal to 0. So can I write like this? Observe carefully. A of I 0. I'll copy this one again. This 0 I am replacing with I because this has to be repeated with the other one also. Right. So I am replacing this 0 with I. Got it? Now, if you observe for J, this value is fixed. 0, 1. This value is fixed. This can be replaced with J. Follow carefully, all of you. Got it? Now, if you observe here, still we are, what we are doing, each time we are performing the multiplication, for the first time it is 0 And whatever we are getting, that we are adding with the value of 1 here. Isn't it or not? Observe carefully. Here, we have performed the multiplication with the value of 0 here. And whatever we are getting here, the value should be added to the next value with the value of 1 here, with the value of 1 here. Got it? Now, how can I generalize this one is, we can generalize this one by simply writing the k value. This can be replaced with k, where the k value is starting from 0 to 2. So I can write this one like, no, someone is telling like if you observe here, this value is this one, right? This value is this one, a of 0, 1. We should not go here. How we are performing the multiplication? This value should be multiplied with this value, and this value should be multiplied with this value, and this value should be multiplied with this value. Isn't it or not? That is a matrix multiplication, how we are doing. And all the values should be added, right? So that's why I have written a of 0, 0. That is to be multiplied with b of 0, 0. And then which is added to. What is this one? A of 0, 1, which is multiplied with b of 1, 0. Right, and then it is added to a of 0, 2, and it is to be multiplied with b of 2, 0. This is right. There is no mistake in that. Right, and we have generalized this one with I and j. Got it? And still we can generalize this one by simply saying, I will be taking this 0, okay, this 0 whatever we have and 1 whatever we have. This is a repetition process. What I want to do is, sum I will be taking, sorry, I have to do here. I will be replacing this 0 with k value, and what I want to do, let me write this one, copy this. I will be replacing this one with k, and I will be adding this one to some another variable, which is our sum variable, let us consider. And repeatedly you need to perform this value, and it should be stored in the variable called sum. For your understanding, I am writing sum. So initially what happens, let us see first. The k value should be from here. The k value should be from 0 to 1, and then it should be 2, because we have options of 0, 1, 2. Got it, all of you? So initially the k value is 0. So a of i 0 star. Observe, okay, I'm telling that one what I'm doing. See here, 0, 0, and here it is 1, 1. And here it is 2, 2. Now what I want to do is, I want to make this one as a generalized one, where I have replaced this 0, 0. Wherever we have that one, I have replaced that one with k. Okay. Now what I have done, so this has been converted to a of I k star b of 0 k. Now this should be added with some sum. I'll tell you what is this sum actually. Initially the sum value will be 0. Okay. So this will be 0 initially plus sum. Now what happens, a of 0, 0, for the first time k value is 0, so a of I 0 star b of 0 j will be added with the sum, that value is 0. Now that will be stored in turn again in sum. Now we have this first value product stored in sum. Now k value will be incremented. K value will be what now? A of this part, a of 0, 1, and b of a of I 1 star b of 1 j. Now whatever product you get, that will be added to the already added to the sum. So already in the sum we have this product, that will be added to that sum, and the final value will be stored in sum. Now the k value will be incremented, and k value will be 2. Now these two product will be done, and that will be added to our sum, which is already having the sum of these two values, and the final value will be stored in sum. Got all of you? This is how we have generalized this matrix multiplication. So the same thing we can write in our code, where we don't want to store in the sum, we want to store in a particular location. So what is our particular location? Our particular location is C of Ij only. So C, this can be replaced with C of Ij, and this can also be replaced with C of Ij. So the same thing I'll be writing here in place of sum. Observe carefully, in place of sum, this can be written like sum plus this one also. So I'll be writing C of Ij plus, same thing I'll copy here. No, you can't write sum equal to removing this one. We can't remove this one. Why? Because this will get only this part for first iteration. For k equal to 0, you will be getting only up to this part. And after performing this matrix multiplication, this product that should be stored in some variable, SVM variable, and then k value will be incremented, and we will be getting this part, and this part product should be added to this value. So that's why I'm adding with this sum. Got it? Now sum equal to, I will be copying this one as it is because we have to use that. So this is how matrix multiplication can be done. And how, but I have forgot to write the iteration for k. We need to write down the iteration for k also. K iteration starts from 0, 1, 2. So what can we do? We need to add one more iteration here. What is that? For k equal to 0, k less than, what is this 2 here? That 2 is our, what is this 2? This 2 is not 2, this is our 3. Three times it has to be repeated. What is this three? This three can be the row size or the column size of this one, right? So we can write here R2, sorry, we can write here C2, or you can write R1 because normally both are same. K plus plus. Are you understanding what I'm telling? Why I'm writing C2 here? In our example, C2 is nothing but C2 is nothing. In our example, K is to be repeated how many times? Three times. Three times is nothing but these many number of times, or it is equal to these many number of times. What is this value? This value is R2, or sorry, this value is C2, or this value is R1. In place of C2, you can also write R1 also, no issue in that. Okay, now this has to be repeated, and this is the end of this K, and this is the end of this J, and this is one more we need to put. This is the end of this I. Got all of you? But this is not the end of your program. We are successful in getting this value, but for the next time to get this value, already some value will be there in C of Iz, because after repeating the complete thing, this will be repeated for one time for getting this value. But for the next time we need to get this value, this C of Ij should be initially 0 because it will be already having some value. So before starting this one, what can we do is we can write C of Ij should be initialized to 0 each time it is starting, repeating its process. Why I have written this statement? Why I have added this statement? Because see, for the first time k equal to 0, you will be repeating the same process and you will be getting the value in this place. But next time, if you are starting with k equal to 1, got it? Now what happens for J? For the next time, what happens? You need to get this value. For that, already some value will be stored that should be made 0. Why? Because that value should not be added to the next value. So we are making C of Iz to 0. Understood all of you what I'm doing? What I'm doing? How you'll be getting this value? This value you will be getting by multiplying this value with this value, and this value with this value, and this value with this value. I think you all are familiar with matrix normal multiplication. Now to go with the next iteration, we need to make this C of Iz to 0 because the already having value should be made 0. Got it? So this is how simple matrix multiplication can be done. We can copy the entire code here. And the same thing can be added here after reading the A and B values. What is the next step we need to perform? Perform the logic for matrix multiplication. So that's why I'm copying here whatever code we have written. Okay, so this is the logic for performing the matrix multiplication. So we have done this part also. Now after this, what we need to do? We need to display the values of C. How can we display the values of C? We can use the same logic here, whatever we have written. Reading the value, simply we need to replace that one of value. We can write product of A and B matrix, and simply you can write this value should be changed. What is this value? This value should be What is this logic? What is this loop? The value of C, can you tell me? We are trying to display the C matrix, right? Can you tell me what is the size of C? What is the size of C? The size of C will be equal to, in this diagram, if you see, R1 by C2, right? So we need to write here R1 and we need to write here C. So we have performed the matrix multiplication and we are trying to display the values. So this is the end of your code. So someone have asked me the doubt. So I repeat here, someone is asking how we got 0k here. Observe here. Sorry, it is not 0k. I think it is kj. This is k. Observe here. Kj. Thank you very much. So this is ik and this is kj. This is that means for the first time i0 and then 0j. Got it? So the same thing I need to copy there. I have done mistake there. I need to write like this. IK star KJ. Very good. So the same thing I need to modify here also. Got it, all of you? Understood now how this has been done? How the matrix multiplication has been done? Now what you all need to do is, I will be uploading this one. I will be uploading this one in the classroom. This complete video. You go through this video and you try to type this code and check whether you are getting the perfect output or not. Now make sure, like, you should display your output in the form of matrix. For getting that, you need to write on some more statements like printf slash and all those things you need to do. You do on your own that. Understood, all of you? So we have done this part also, displaying the value. So these are all the steps we need to perform, we need to follow to perform the matrix multiplication. Right, all of you? If any mistake is there, you please tell me in this. I think I've done, everything is right. Only the thing here I got confused. Here we need to write K and J. That is right. Okay, very good. So let us stop today's class here. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. See, someone is asking me how to get this k value. I'll tell you once again. See, if you observe here, we are performing the same task. For your understanding, I will divide this one like this. Okay, we are taking the first two values product, and that one is added to the next two values, and that will be added to the next two values. Now, if you observe here, there is a similarity in this one. What we are doing repeatedly, we are taking the I value, same I value, but there is a difference in the this place. Here it is 0, 0 for the first time. For the next time it is 1, 1. For the next time it is 2, 2. Now can we generalize this one to like this? What I have done, observe carefully. I have done the same thing. I have taken directly here, where I have replaced this 0 with k. So a of ik plus b of kz. Now, how many times you need to repeat this one? K value should be 0, 1, 2. So that's where k value should be repeated to 0, 1, 2. Now, what we have done, each time you take this value, you perform this operation. And for the first time, let us consider, for the first time, it will be i0 star b of 0 j. That will be done, that operation will be done, and that should be added to the sum I told. Initially, the sum value will be 0. So we will be getting this value stored in the sum. Next iteration, this will be I1. Okay, because k value is 1, I1 and b multiplied with b of 1j. And this value should be added to the sum. What is there in the sum? In the sum, already this product is there, that will be added to our sum. Got it? Now for the next iteration, k value is 3. So you will be getting this one, and this value will be added to the sum. In the sum, already this entire thing has been multiplied and added, and that value is already available in the sum, and we are adding the sum. So that is why we are repeating this process. We are generalizing this entire process by replacing this with the k. So the same thing has been done here. Now for k value, why I have written c2? Because for our example, we are repeating three times. Why we are repeating three times? Because this one is 3 and this one is 3. So I am repeating these three times. Got it? Now, generally, how can we say this is C1 and this is, for this one, this is R1. So we can either write it is, I have written C2. I have to write C1 or R2, right? Why? Because row size and column size are matching, right? Where is that? If row size and column size matching, either you can write C1 or you can write C2. Very good. Either you can write C1 or you can write C2. So let me change this one here also. C1 or R2, anything you can write. R1 or C, not R1 or C2. You can write C1 or R2. See, what is this one? This is the column size of first matrix. What is the column size of first matrix? C1 only. What is the row size of the first matrix? R2 only. Got it? So you can write either C1 or R2. In this place, you can write R2 also. No issue with that, because both are matching. So why we are writing R1 and C2 only? Because we are repeating that one. In our example, we are repeating three times. That means we have three columns or three rows in the second matrix. So that's why we are performing three times. So we can generalize that one by writing like this. Got all of you? So this is how matrix multiplication. So we have come with a final logic way. This is the end of our code. Got all of you? So in the asynchronous mode, you all finish this task and try to display the value, final product of matrix multiplication, the matrix form only. Got it, all of you? You all try the different two test cases. First test case is matrix multiplication is not possible. And second test case is if it is possible, you need to get the product of those two. Got it, all of you? Let us stop here because I got, let me stop this 1 minute.